Now, I've seen and I've read some of your partnerships. You have one also with the DOH. I mean, Turn You On 2.0 is also quite an innovative approach to providing comprehensive sexual and reproductive health education. Can you tell us more, I guess, on the impact of this and how it empowered the Filipino Gen Z youth with accurate and definitely essential information?
Yes. There are like really topics that we have considered taboo or like, if not a taboo, a difficult conversation to have with our Gen Z. So through our platform, we've allowed Gen Z to openly learn and speak about such topics when it comes to sex education and reproductive health. And how we've shared the information, it's through a series of quests and rewards so that it would be a good learning experience that is going to be on nugget-sized pieces, easy to digest, while at the same time getting customized on how they are learning so that we could be able to offer what's that next new lesson that they could be learning based on how they are responding to the learning materials that we've provided to them.
And how did you see the impact of this with your students?
First, we saw that there are more Filipinos getting interested to learn something new. More subjects, more different lesson that they are consuming in our website. Next to that, it's not just about like opening a new link or finding out a certain topic or headline. We saw them really digesting and completing the lessons, the learning materials. So the completion rate has also been improving. First, because of a topic that they are interested in. And secondly, because it's a gamified experience wherein it feels like they are really moving upwards and forward to whatever topic that they have chosen to learn.
So comparing to when you started Edukasyon.ph, how many students does it have now currently?
Yes. So on an annual basis, we are now catering to 10 million learners, not just Filipinos, but also abroad. That's a total number of annual students and learners that we're able to reach out. And we have now 1 million registered users that's allowing us to reconnect with our learners, not just on a one-time, but on a continuous basis.
Now, we've discussed sex education this time around. We also read that Binance Academy Scholarship Program. You also had a partnership with that, you know, and it's quite relevant to enhance Web3 education in the country. You know, how are you planning to collaborate with such industry leaders to bridge the gap between traditional education and emerging technologies?
So it's really always a constant conversation of different partners in the ecosystem. We know that like the job market right now has changed and the demands for the skills have also been like very tech driven. So what we've been doing is having that constant conversations with different companies so that we are more aware of what are the qualifications and skill sets that they are looking for their future talents. Knowing that, we make sure that there's going to be a learning experience available in our platform. And what we've discovered, it's not always a technical hard skill. It comes with the soft skills, such as like communication skills, having that confidence to speak about their thoughts, their ideas to their future employers. So having that information, that's the kind of lessons we develop in our platform and create learning experiences for that.
So aside from those two with DOH and then with Binance, are there any other institutions or collaborations that you can share with us to help Edukasyon also, of course, in pushing for really innovative kinds of education and encouraging your students?
Yes. One of like the big projects that we are leaning towards would be civic education, wherein we would want our Filipino youth actively involved in different government and civic activities. So definitely having partners who believes in civic education would be one approach. Another item is really focused on confidence building to our Filipino youth and empowering them by having access to different opportunities. So having partners for that specific learning is something that we are also proactively looking for.
Now, education technology, it's quite a competitive field. You know, how does Edukasyon.ph stay ahead of that curve, both in terms of technological innovations and, you know, also meeting the evolving expectations of students and the parents?
First, it's always making sure that we are connected to our students on the ground and really on a first-hand basis. Together with the students, it's also making sure that we also hear the concerns of their parents. So the experiences that we develop both online or and offline would always be picking up the insights and the recent behaviors of our users. And then together with that is making sure also that Edukasyon is very much in touch with the latest development regionally and globally, so that all that latest technology, especially right now with the conversations on AI, Web 3.0, those are the items that we want to make sure available also in our tech platform.
No, it's great that you mentioned the first one, of course, connecting. How does Edukasyon cultivate that sense of community and support among its users to foster a environment for students to feel encouraged and to want to learn?
It's always making sure that we are present and connected, especially now that classes is about to open nationwide soon at the end of this August. We are not just like a platform present on the website. We are very much present in conversations of our youth, very much engaged online and even visiting some of their schools so that we could hear their concerns and what are their current practices, and making sure that it is very much integrated to everything that we offer.
Lastly, Grace, you know, what aspirations and goals do you have for the platform, you know, in the coming years? How do you see its impact extending beyond individual education journeys to, of course, broader societal development?
Our value in Edukasyon is making sure that the learning experience is always a joyful experience, beyond just like a compliance or a grade that our students want to achieve. We want to make sure that learning is fun. Learning is enjoyable. And we want to make sure that every touch point that we embark on, whether it's our website, a social media account, or a school visit, we want to make sure that the students are having fun on those learning experiences. Because we know every time we do that, our Filipino learners would be encouraged to learn something new again right after that.
Grace David of Edukasyon.ph. Grace, it was so good talking to you.
Thank you.